and this is Dalia. I'm reading The Vampire Diaries, The Struggle. I'm on chapter 10, and this is part 3. "This is the last thing I'll ever ask," Elena said, "and I promise that, I swear." "Don't," said Meredith, suddenly serious. "Don't, Elena. You might be sorry later." "Now, you're taking up prophecy too," Elena said. And then she asked, "So how are we going to get hold of Caroline's house key for an hour or so?" "November 9th, Saturday. Dear Diary, I'm sorry it's been so long. Lately I've been too busy or depressed, or both, to write you. Besides, with everything that's happened, I'm almost afraid to keep a diary at all anymore. But I need someone to turn to, because right now there's not a single human being, not a single person on earth, that I'm not keeping something from. Bonnie and Meredith can't know the truth about Stefan, and Stefan can't know the truth about Damon. Aunt Judith can't know about anything, and Bonnie and Meredith know about Caroline and the diary. Stefan doesn't. Stefan knows about the vervain I use every day now. Bonnie and Meredith don't, even though I've even given both of them satchels full of the stuff. One good thing, it seems to work, or at least I haven't been sleepwalking again since that night. But it would be a lie to say I haven't been dreaming about Damon. He's in all my nightmares. My life is full of lies right now. And I need someone to be completely honest with. I'm going to hide this diary under the loose floorboard in the closet so that no one will find it, even if I drop dead and they clean out my room. Maybe one of Margaret's grandchildren will be playing in there someday and will pry up the board and pull it out. But until then, nobody. This diary is in my last secret. Well, I don't know why I'm thinking about death and dying. That Bonnie's craze. She's the one who thinks it would be so romantic. I know what it's like, really. There are nothing romantic about it. When Mom and Dad died, just the worst feelings in the world. I want to live for a good long time. Marry Stefan and be happy. And there's no reason why I can't, once all these problems are behind us. Except that there are times when I get scared, and I don't believe that, and there are little things that shouldn't matter. But they bother me, like why Stefan still wears Catherine's ring around his neck, even though I know he loves me. Like why he never said he loves me, even though I know it's true. Doesn't matter, everything will work out. It has to work out, and then we'll be together. And be happy. There's no reason why we can't. There's no reason why we can't. There's no reason. And I'll continue on to part 4.